All right, now I've got hooks that I've created on all three of these scrapers, and we're ready to go do a demonstration. But to be honest with you, I don't really use hand scrapers that much anymore. They kind of take too much of a toll on my hands when I'm, you know, bending that steel, and they kind of jack my thumbs up as much abuse as my hands take. Plus, as hard as I can push it through the material, the blade gets so hot that it actually burns my thumbs and fingers. So I mean, I'll use them in certain situations where I just have to like feather a little joint or something like that. But I primarily will use this the Stanley number 80 scraper plane. I mean, once you get the hang of this plane, it's just an amazing tool. It'll take the lightest, finest little pass and cut, or it'll, if you flex the blade using this thumb screw, it will take the most aggressive hogging cut that you can imagine. But I'll show more of that when I demonstrate all the edges. And I would sharpen both sides of this, but the blade now is too short. It used to be much longer where I could sharpen both sides, but now if I put it in here, the jaw vices will damage the hook. What's so amazing about it then is how easy it is to resharpen and freshen up your hook. You saw how easy it is. It just takes no time. It doesn't take nearly the amount of time that it does to sharpen a plane iron. And so for any situations where you have glue that have come together, a panel, you can float that glue off so quickly that you'll just be shocked. You can't sand it off as fast as you can cut it off with this. And this is an original, this one's made in England. I bought this in the mid 80s. I think I paid $18 for it. There are reproductions of this, the Stanley number 80, and Woodcraft sells one. But I've also seen these more vintage ones on eBay for around $10. So, you can always come up with these blades, you know, brand new fresh blades if you need one. And like I said, mine used to be long and I'm probably about due to get a new one. But I just try to grind this thing down until it won't go anymore. But it's a fine tool for anybody that's doing woodworking or even carpentry or cabinet making. It's just a great tool because it'll get you to a sanding place faster than you can belt sand or aggressive sand too. And it'll, like I said, it'll cut through epoxy and glue and just come back for more, and you can sharpen that, put that hook on that blade so easily that you don't have to go, I don't want to touch that because it's got all that glue and epoxy. Man, you just get after it, and then you can clean the sole up. You can dress the sole on a piece of sand, wet dry sandpaper, and clean it up. See, I've got some embedded glue on it that I'll probably need to do, but this one's over, you know, well over 20 years old, and I wouldn't trade it for anything. One of the reasons this is such a valuable tool is that with a traditional handheld scraper, when you're bending and flexing, and you're especially as strong as a lot of us are, I'm pretty strong still, and I can cut really, really fast with tools. This thing gets so hot I can't even hold it. And even wearing gloves, it gets hot like you can't believe, just from the friction of cutting, you know, especially hardwoods. And it jacks my thumbs up, bending that piece of metal and holding it at that angle to make it cut efficiently. It doesn't cut straight. It cuts more efficiently when the blade is bent. And so it just jacks my hands up and it gives me cramps in my thumbs. That's why this is so fantastic, because it has these beautiful ergonomic handles. And so you can put your hand on this and feel how hot the sole is when you're cutting. I mean, it just gets really, really hot. Far enough back up here with this cast iron that you can just go all day. Got a beautiful way to really power through the material. And the way you flex the blade is with this thumb screw here. That's how you flex the blade and determine how aggressive you're going to cut. But I'll get into that more when I actually do a little demo in the shop of cutting with this.